Hello friends, welcome back in this video session of Pharmaceutical Organic Chemistry 1 Practicals. So in today's video session, we will be actually starting our practicals. Okay, so in the previous video, I have already explained the overview of our practical syllabus. We have explained what are the experiments we are going to perform in the practicals, and I have also explained the scheme of your examination. Now, in this pandemic situation, as I mentioned, we will be covering the theoretical aspect of these practicals through the presentation, and if possible, we will perform some of the experiments and we will record those and we will show you in the video format. So let's get started. So in pharmaceutical organic chemistry practicals, the main part of your syllabus is the systematic qualitative analysis of unknown organic compound. As I told you, any unknown organic compound is given to you and you are supposed to identify the compound, what it could be. Okay, so this systematic qualitative analysis, that is the analysis and identification of unknown organic compound, it constitute a very important aspect of the experimental organic chemistry. ये बहुत ही important kind of experiment हम organic chemistry में करते हैं, क्योंकि as a organic chemist कुछ भी compound अगर हमारे पास आता है या दिया जाता है तो उसकी identity, उसका analysis करना as a organic chemist, that is very important and we should able to identify what that compound could be. So we can perform series of qualitative analysis test and we can reveal or we can give the confirmation the given unknown organic compound is so and so. Okay, although it is often possible to establish the structure of compound which is unknown to you using instrumental techniques. Now there are very modern and sophisticated techniques like spectroscopy or chromatography nowadays, and these instrumental techniques can very accurately identify what compound it could be or what the given unknown compound could be. But most of the times we should not go for these high-end techniques. We can do some simple qualitative test and we can identify the compound. Every time we cannot go for spectroscopic technique or chromatographic technique, even it is not feasible. And in the laboratory you may not have all these high-end technologies. So in laboratory what we can do, we can do some primitive test and sometimes you can very easily identify the compound. You can save your time, and these tests, qualitative tests, are very simple. They are very cost effective. They are simply the chemical test or some kind of physical determination, right? Physical constant determination. So by performing these tests, very easily you can identify the compound. So that is an importance of doing systematic qualitative analysis. So in these experiments, we will carry out several qualitative tests, and these tests will allow us to identify the organic compound. Okay, so this is the brief introduction. Then various books have different approaches for analyzing and identifying the unknown organic compound, but what is more common, that is in all these books we can observe a systematic approach is important. How systematically we can identify the compound, and then this systematic approach is based on the scheme which we will be discussing in the coming slide, and this will give the reliable results where we can rely, okay, so whatever unknown organic compound is given to me, that is salicylic acid or that is benzoic acid and so on. Okay, then each functional group has a particular set of chemical properties, and these functional group, because of these characteristic chemical property, they actually allow us to identify them. I have already mentioned in the previous session, like functional groups, they impart a very characteristic property. मैंने बताया था कि फ्रूटी ओडर कोई कंपाउंड का आ रहा है, तो फ्रूटी ओडर इज बिकॉज ऑफ द ईस्टर फंक्शनैलिटी। तो हमें इससे पता चल सकता है कि कंपाउंड में ईस्टर फंक्शनैलिटी है। अगर समझो कंपाउंड का स्मेल फिशी स्मेल आ रहा है, सो फिशी स्मेल इज बिकॉज ऑफ मेनली द अमाइंस। अमाइंस विल गिव द फिशी स्मेल। ओके, इफ द कंपाउंड कंटेन्स द एसीटोन एज अ फंक्शनैलिटी कीटोन, राइट, सो दैट विल गिव अ वेरी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक स्मेल। सो बेस्ड ऑन दीज केमिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टीज वी कैन ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई द कंपाउंड्स वॉट इट कुड बी। सो सम ऑफ दीज प्रॉपर्टीज वी कैन डेमोन्स्ट्रेट बाई ऑब्जर्विंग द सोल्युबिलिटी बिहेवियर। ईच कंपाउंड हैव इट्स ओन सोल्युबिलिटी। कुछ कंपाउंड्स वाटर सोल्यूबल रहेंगे, कुछ कंपाउंड्स ऑर्गेनिक सॉल्वेंट्स में सोल्यूबल रहेंगे, राइट। दे मे बी फ्रीली सोल्यूबल, दे मे बी प्रैक्टिकली इनसोल्यूबल एंड सो ऑन, और दे मे बी पार्शियली सोल्यूबल। सो वी कैन एनालाइज दीज प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ दीज कंपाउंड्स एंड बेस्ड ऑन दीज वी कैन सेग्रीगेट देम इन टू सेवरल ग्रुप्स और सेवरल क्लासेस, एंड देन वी कैन परफॉर्म अ सीरीज ऑफ केमिकल टेस्ट। वी कैन डिटरमाइन देयर मेल्टिंग पॉइंट और बॉइलिंग पॉइंट बेस्ड ऑन द नेचर ऑफ द कंपाउंड, एंड वी कैन गेट क्लोजर टू द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ द कंपाउंड। ओके, वी कैन परफॉर्म सम कन्फर्मेटरी टेस्ट एंड देन वी कैन ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई द कंपाउंड। वी कैन ऑल्सो डू द डेरिवेटिव प्रिपरेशन वेयर वी कन्वर्ट द लिक्विड कंपाउंड इन टू अ सॉलिड डेरिवेटिव विच विल बी मोर प्योर, एंड देन दैट विल गिव अ शार्प मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, एंड फ्रॉम दैट वी कैन ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई द कंपाउंड आइडेंटिटी। ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट अबाउट द सिस्टमेटिक क्वालिटेटिव अप्रोच फॉर एनालाइजिंग एंड आइडेंटिफाइंग द अननोन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। ओके, सो वॉट डू वी मीन बाय द सिस्टमेटिक अप्रोच? सो वट आर द स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व इन एनालाइजिंग द अननोन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड? अभी समझो आप प्रैक्टिकल लेबोरेटरी में हैं एंड यू आर द ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट, एंड इफ समबडी इज गिविंग यू एक्स वाई जेड कंपाउंड एज अननोन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड एंड यू हैव बीन आस्क्ड टू आइडेंटिफाई द कंपाउंड, सो दिस थिंग्स यू ऑलरेडी एक्सरसाइज्ड, यू ऑलरेडी परफॉर्म सम आइडेंटिफिकेशन टेस्ट फॉर इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस इन द प्रीवियस सेमिस्टर, राइट। नाउ इन दिस सेमिस्टर वी आर मेनली फोकसिंग ऑन द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। I told you there are millions of organic compounds and every year almost 10,000 new compounds have been added in the nature. So it is very essential we should have to have some qualitative test so that we can identify these compounds. So as a organic chemist, you should able to identify these compounds. So if unknown organic compound is given, then you have to perform the qualitative test in a very systematic and sequential way. Otherwise, agar hum haphazardly kar jate hain, to end results are not reliable. Hame pata nahi chalega ki compound jo diya hai, wo kaun sa compound hai. To iske liye hame sequentially aur systematic qualitative analysis karna bahut hi important hai. So, your compound which is given to you, that could be a solid or it could be a liquid. So as far as your first year BPharm is concerned, we will be giving you mostly the solid organic compounds. Okay, and few popular liquid compounds are also given. Okay, so we will see how these unknown compounds can be identified. So what systematic approach we should adopt? So first, what we have to do, the first step soon after getting the sample, that is you have to perform the preliminary test. Okay, so in today's lecture we will be mainly focusing in the step one. So in step one we will be discussing what are the preliminary tests we should undergo whenever we receive the sample. In preliminary test we can do physical examination of the sample, like what is the state of the sample, what is the color of the sample, and what is the odor of the sample if it is having certain odor. Okay, or you can also mention if it is odorless. So based on that we can categorize the compound what we have received into a several possibilities. Then we can also perform the ignition test. We can ignite the sample and then we can observe the flame. And then we can also perform the test for unsaturation, where we can get idea about whether your compound is saturated or it is unsaturated. That means whether it presents double bond or triple bond, or it is simply a singly bonded. So this is what we do in a preliminary test, and these are the preliminary test which will guide you to certain extent the possibility of the given compound. Then once you are done with the preliminary test, you will get information, okay, which is not so good, but it is having some indication the possibility of what the compound could be. And then you can go for the detection of elements. So I told you, organic compounds are the compounds which contains one or more carbon which is covalently bonded with other elements atoms. So what these other elements atoms, it could be a nitrogen, it could be a sulfur, or it could be a any other element. So we will detect in the given organic compound whether other elements are present. जैसे कि मेरे कंपाउंड में जो भी अननोन कंपाउंड दिया है उसमें नाइट्रोजन प्रेजेंट है क्या. सो वी विल डू अ नाइट्रोजन टेस्ट एंड इफ इट इज पॉजिटिव हमको पता चल जाएगा कि नाइट्रोजन प्रेजेंट है स्ट्रक्चर में. देर इज अ टेस्ट फॉर सल्फर. सो इफ दिस इज निगेटिव दैट मीन्स योर कंपाउंड डज नॉट हैव अ सल्फर. देन एक्स रिप्रेजेंट्स द हैलोजन लाइक क्लोरीन आयोडीन एंड सो ऑन. So that can also be performed, and you will get an idea about the presence of these elements in the compound. So for that you have to perform a Lassange test, or this is also referred as a detection of element, where you have to fuse a metal, sodium metal, with your compound, and then you have to prepare the extract, and then you have to perform the test for nitrogen, sulfur and halogen. So we'll discuss in detail, and these are also very important because these will give you actually the presence or absence of certain elements which are very common in the organic compounds. So once you are done with the second step, that is detection of element, then you should move for the solubility test. Because the compounds have a very particular solubility in a solvent, so you can check the solubility of the compound. And based on the solubility, we have the seven groups in which we have classified the entire organic compounds. Okay, so based on the solubility it has, in which solvent it is giving a good solubility, based on that we have categorized into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 groups. So these seven groups are helping us to identify the compound. So we can put them in a particular group based on what kind of solubility it has in a given solvent, and then we can proceed further for the analysis. Once you are done with the solubility, that is the third step, then you should go for functional group detection. So there are certain functional group tests which are basically the chemical test. Using certain chemicals and reagents, we can identify the presence or absence of particular functionality in the structure. For example, if amino functionality is present, we will do certain functional group test for amine group, and if they are present, then it is giving an indication that there is a amino group. Additionally, you also perform the preliminary test. So in preliminary test, you may be having a fishy kind of odor, so that is suggesting there could be a amino group. Additionally, you are performing element detection, in that there is a presence of nitrogen. So presence of nitrogen, additionally the fishy odor, and you are getting the amino group test positive, is giving strong indication that the amino group may be present in the given unknown organic compound. And then you can confirm that by doing the determination of physical constant. Physical constant are nothing but the determination of its melting point. If the compound is solid in nature, if the compound is liquid in nature, you can also perform the boiling point determination. And you know, these are the physical constant. So for particular solid substance, the melting point is fixed. It is very characteristic, it is very peculiar for that substance. If I have an aniline, it is in a liquid form, so that aniline will boil at a particular temperature, and that is very unique. So if I am suspecting my compound is aniline, I will perform the boiling point, and then I will match that boiling point with the literature boiling point of the aniline. If it is matching, and then you can also have the support of these tests, which is indicating the presence or absence of the aniline, and then you can confirm that the given unknown organic compound could be aniline, or it could be a salicylic acid or whatsoever. And then if required, if you are not confident here about the identity, you may go for the derivative preparation. So in derivative preparation, as I mentioned, you convert your compound into a suitable derivative by following some simple chemical reaction, and then these derivatives will be more pure, which have a very sharp melting point. So you can find out the melting point of that particular derivative, and then you can very easily identify with very surety that the given compound is so and so. So this is what is called as the systematic qualitative analysis approach for identifying and analyzing the unknown organic compounds. So first is preliminary test, then go for the element detection by Lessence test, then third is the solubility test, then functional group detection, then physical constant determination, and if required, you can also go for the derivative preparation. Now in today's session, we will be discussing mainly about the preliminary test. Now in preliminary test, as the name implies, preliminary matlab jo bahut hi primary level ke hai. So under preliminary test, we can have the physical examination. We can examine, we can observe as an analyst chemist, as the organic chemist, we can observe the sample, and then we can have certain predictions here. So under physical examination, the first is analyzing the nature or the state of the compound. So the given compound could be a solid or it could be a liquid. Okay, so agar samjho diya hua sample solid state mein hai. So solid state compounds are generally high molecular weight compounds, and they usually have more than 6 carbon atoms in the structure. And what are the examples? So if you have your unknown sample in the solid format, then it could be a carbohydrate, it could be acid, it could be a phenol, amine, and sugars. If it is in a liquid form, then they are low molecular weight compounds. So it could be a alcohol, ethers, esters, aliphatic amines, aldehyde, ketones, and hydrocarbons. So all these compounds are usually liquid in nature. Okay, so this is the simplest way you can you can distinguish the given compound based on its solid or liquid state. You can rule out the possibilities. Let's say if you have a solid substance, you can rule out the possibilities of presence of these type of compounds, right? If it is a liquid, then it won't be a carbohydrate, it won't be a common acids, amines, and so on. Okay, so this will give a brief idea, and this will be a kind of guideline. Based on that, you can categorize your compound, and then it will help you to identify the compound. So the first is nature or the state of the compound. Then second important physical examination is the color of the compound. You know, in pharmaceuticals, most of the compounds are colorless, okay? But there are several compounds which have a very peculiar color. For example, the pale yellow color is very peculiar in nitro compounds. So agar nitro compounds aapko diye hai as a unknown organic compounds, then you can easily make out if it is pale yellow color, then immediately it should click you that it could be a nitro compound. It could be a dinitrobenzene, it could be a nitrophenol, it could be a quinones, it could be a iodoforms. So this is with respect to the solid state compound. Okay, agar solid hai to ye compound ho sakte hai, dinitrobenzene, nitrophenol, quinone, and iodoform. Agar pale yellow color hai और कंपाउंड लिक्विड है देन डेफिनेटली इट कुड बी अ नाइट्रोबेंजीन. ओके इट इज गिविंग एन इंडिकेशन देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट इट कुड बी अ नाइट्रोबेंजीन. ओके देन यू कैन चेक द टेस्ट फॉर नाइट्रोजन एंड देन अदर कन्फर्मेटरी टेस्ट. इफ योर कंपाउंड इज येलो ऑरेंज इट इज इंडिकेटिंग इट कुड बी अ नाइट्रो एनिलीन. देन इफ इट इज द रेड कलर इट कुड बी अजो कंपाउंड और इट कुड बी अ मीथाइल ऑरेंज. इफ इट इज पिंक इन कलर इट कुड बी द अल्फा नेप्थॉल इट कुड बी अ बीटा नेप्थॉल और इट कुड बी अ रेसोर्सिनॉल. ओके सो दीज ऑब्जर्वेशंस यू कैन मेक वेरी केयरफुली एंड देन यू कैन पुट अ इन्फरेंस इन योर रिकॉर्ड बुक. इफ इट हैज अ ग्रीनिश येलो कलर इट कुड बी अ ऑर्थो और मेटा नाइट्रोबेंजाल्डिहाइड एंड दिस बेंजाल्डिहाइड ऑल्सो हैव पर्टिकुलर ओडर फ्रॉम विच यू कैन ऑल्सो get some indication. If it is having a dark brown color, it could be a phenols or it could be a amines. If it is colorless, then you have ample of possibilities. That is, it could be a simple acid, it could be alcohol, it could be ester, it could be ketone, the hydrocarbons. Urea is also colorless, thiourea is also colorless, then acetamide, acetanilide, benzamide, naphthalene, etc. Okay, naphthalene you can make out by smelling that. Okay, and this will help you again for identifying the compound. Then the third physical examination is the odor of the compound. Okay, now here you should remember and you should keep in mind that you are dealing with the organic compounds. Some of the organic compounds are very hazardous and their fumes, their odor is even toxic. It will create a problem to our health. So whenever you are performing the odor test for your given organic compound, you should be very careful. Okay, you should not inhale those smells. Okay, inhale those fumes. You should be very careful and just you have to have a sense of that odor. So if it is pleasant odor, then you know it could be alcohol. It could be aromatic hydrocarbons, it could be ether, alkyl halides like chloroform, chlorobenzene, etc. If it has a fruity odor, as I mentioned, it could be ester. If it has a fishy smell, you know the fishy smell, it could be the aromatic amines. Kerosene. Kerosene, you already aware, right? So kerosene have a very particular smell, and if you are getting a kerosene smell, then it could be a hydrocarbons, okay, chain of hydrocarbons. Then mothball, the best example you can have here, the naphthalene. Naphthalene will have a very peculiar smell, and if naphthalene is given as a unknown sample, very easily you can identify even by simple odor of the naphthalene. Okay, of course you have to perform the other test and you have to confirm it is a naphthalene. Then benzaldehydes, nitrobenzene, they have a bitter almond odor. Okay, so you can imagine what could be the smell of bitter almond, and if it is so, it could be a benzaldehyde or it could be a nitrobenzene. These are usually in a liquid form. Then pungent or irritating kind of odor if you are getting, and that is giving an indication it could be acids like aliphatic acid, acid chloride or formaldehyde and so on. And if it is phenol or cresol, it could be a metacresol, paracresol, then it will have a carbolic or phenolic kind of smell. Phenols will have a very particular carbolic odor. Okay, and based on that you can also get a hint of what the compound could be. So these are the three physical examination, that is the state of the sample, whether it is solid or liquid, then we have seen the color of the sample, and then the odor of the sample. So these will help you to broadly categorize the given compound, what it could be. Okay, then there are certain preliminary tests which we should do, and in the preliminary test, the first test is the flame test. So as the name implies, what you have to do, you have to take your sample and you have to put it on the spatula. So you have the simple metallic spatulas what we use in a laboratory, और उस स्पैचुला में हमें क्या करना है, वी हैव टू टेक अ स्मॉल क्वांटिटी ऑफ योर सैंपल. इफ इट इज सॉलिड यू कैन टेक अ पिंच ऑफ योर सैंपल. इफ इट इज लिक्विड यू कैन ऐड अ फ्यू ml और फ्यू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ योर लिक्विड सैंपल ऑन द स्पैचुला एंड देन पुट दिस स्पैचुला डायरेक्टली ऑन द ओपन फ्लेम. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो रेफर्ड एज द इग्निशन टेस्ट. सैंपल को क्या करना है, इग्नाइट करना है, सैंपल को बर्न करना है. एंड देन वेन यू आर बर्निंग द सैंपल यू शुड केयरफुली ऑब्जर्व द कलर ऑफ द फ्लेम. ओके, फ्लेम को ऑब्जर्व करना है, सैंपल को बर्न करना है स्पैचुला में लेके फ्लेम में, एंड देन यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व द फ्लेम. सो द कलर ऑफ द फ्लेम, इफ इट इज हैविंग अ नॉन सूटी फ्लेम देन इट विल बी एलिफेटिक कंपाउंड्स. इफ इट इज अ सूटी फ्लेम इट कुड बी अरोमेटिक कंपाउंड्स. सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सूटी फ्लेम? So this picture is indicating the sooty flame. So either you can take the spatula because a very small quantity of sample heated directly on the flame with the spatula is sufficient. If you are not able to get that, you can also use a china dish like this, porcelain dish, and in porcelain dish you can put your sample and then you can burn it. Now you can see here the sample has been burnt out and there are some blackish kind of flame here. So this is called as the soot. Okay, so this is a sooty flame. So if you are observing this kind of picture or the flame, that is referred as a sooty flame. So this indicates your compound is aromatic. If you are not getting this kind of blackish sooty flame, then it will be aliphatic compound. So this is very important. You are getting the categorization of given compound into aromatic or aliphatic. If you are getting ammonical odor, you have experienced the smell of ammonia. So if ammonical odor is coming after heating this, then it could be a urea, it could be a thiourea, or it could be amides. If it chars and swell without the melting, okay, it is charring. Charring means it is converting into a very blackish kind of product and then it is swelling without melting. So it is not getting melted. Immediately it is swelling and then it is converted into a char. Then it could be a sulfur containing compounds. Okay, in these kinds of compounds will be a sulfur containing compounds. So this is a flame test or the ignition test. And based on that, you can have inference about these kind of possibilities of the compound. Then flame test or the ignition test also give the inference about these kind of compounds. So if you are getting the melting and charring with a smell of burnt sugar, then it could be a carbohydrate. Then if it is producing coughing upon the charring, that means you are burning the sample and then whatever fumes are getting produced, those fumes are causing coughing to you, then it could be a benzoic acid, salicylic acid, etc. If it chars without the melting, it could be again a sulfanilic acid, it could be a starch, it could be uric acid. Okay, then the next test under the preliminary test is the Bellston test. Now in this Bellston test, what we have to do, we have to prepare a loop of copper wire. Okay, so we have to take a copper wire and at the one end of the copper wire we can make a loop, that is we can take the copper wire and we can make a small turnings there, right? We can make a loop of copper wire and then this copper wire we can heat it directly on the flame till the flame is no longer colored. So if it has any impurities in the copper wire, that will be burnt out. So your copper wire is now free from any impurities, and then this loop of the copper wire you can dip into your sample. If it is a solid, you can have some smear of the solid sample, or you can sprinkle some of the solid sample on the loop. If it is liquid, you can dip that into a liquid sample and then you burn that on the flame. So if the flame is producing a green flame, then it could be urea, it could be chloride, bromide, etc. If it is burning without the green flame, it could be fluorides, that is indicating with this particular Bellston test. Okay, Then next important test in the preliminary test, that is the test for unsaturation. As I mentioned, you can divide your organic compounds in two classes, saturated compounds and unsaturated compounds. Unsaturated compounds are the compounds which have the presence of double or triple bond in the structure. So you can perform the Baer's test, that is also referred as the action of potassium permanganate, KMnO4. So here what you need to do, you need to take your substance. If it is a solid, you can take a pinch of 0.1 gram of your substance. If it is liquid, you can take 0.1 ml of your 0.1 or 0.2 ml of your sample. Then add 2 ml of water, then you have to mix that well, and then you can add 2 drops of dilute KMnO4 solution. Now you know what is the color of the KMnO4 solution. KMnO4 is a strong oxidizing agent and it will have a deep purple color. Okay, now you can see here with this diagram, this test tube contains your sample which you have dissolved in a water, and then from the dropper you are adding drops of potassium permanganate. So you can see the color of the potassium permanganate is purple, and the test tube contains the sample under examination which you want to identify whether it is saturated or unsaturated. So the moment you add your potassium permanganate, and then you can slightly shake the test tube, if the potassium permanganate color is getting decolorized, उसका मतलब है अगर पोटेशियम परमैंगनेट का कलर डीकलराइज हो रहा है, निकल जा रहा है, एंड देन इट इज रिटेनिंग द ओरिजिनल कलर ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन और इट इज टर्निंग लिटिल बिट ब्राउनिश टाइप, दैट इंडिकेट्स द बेयर्स टेस्ट इज पॉजिटिव. दैट मीन्स देर इज अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ डबल बॉन्ड और ट्रिपल बॉन्ड इन द गिवन सैंपल, देर इज अ अनसैचुरेशन इन द सैंपल. If the color of the potassium permanganate is remaining as it is, that means it is negative test. It is showing a purple color. So KMnO4 has imparted its own color to the solution. So why this happens? Why you are getting a positive test for unsaturated compound and negative test for the saturated compound? It is very easy. You can see this particular reaction. So this is a sample which has a double bond. इसका मतलब है इसमें अनसैचुरेशन है. सो इफ दिस सैंपल आई एम टेकिंग इन अ टेस्ट ट्यूब एंड देन आई एम एडिंग फ्रॉम द ड्रॉपर द पोटेशियम परमैंगनेट विच इज डीप पर्पल इन कलर, सो व्हाट इट विल डू, द पोटेशियम परमैंगनेट विल ऑक्सीडाइज दिस डबल बॉन्ड एंड देन यू कैन सी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, देर इज अ ओएच ग्रुप विच इज गेटिंग अटैच्ड हियर. ओके, सो पोटेशियम परमैंगनेट इज गेटिंग रिड्यूस्ड इन टू दिस, and because of that it will lose its own color. KMnO4 is deep purple color and MnO2 is colorless, and because of that we can say if there is an unsaturation, KMnO4 will get reduced, it will oxidize this particular sample and you will get a positive test. If KMnO4 is not getting reduced or it is not oxidizing your sample, then you will get a negative test because it will be remaining as it is and it is imparting its own color to the solution. So decolorization of KMnO4 after doing this test will indicate unsaturated or compound which is easily oxidizable. If it is no decolorization, it is a saturated compound. Then similarly you can also perform the test for unsaturation using bromine water. So this is referred as the action of bromine water. So what you can do, you can take your sample, then you can add 2 ml of water, you can mix well or shake well, and then you have to add 2 drops of bromine water from the dropper. Now you can see the bromine water has a brown color. So this is a test tube which have your sample whose saturation or unsaturation you want to detect. So what you can do, you can add a bromine water. Now if bromine is added and if you are getting a no decolorization, so no decolorization will happen when the bromine is not getting reacted with your sample. So no decolorization of bromine water indicates your sample is saturated. If this reaction is happening, so this reaction will happen only when there is an unsaturation in your sample. For example, you have this alkene. So in this alkene, there is a double bond. That means there is a unsaturation. Okay. So there is an unsaturation. So bromine will react with this unsaturation and there will be an addition of bromine. So this is the addition reaction. So you can see the two atoms of bromine are added to these two carbons or the unsaturation, and then the decolorization will happen. So decolorization of bromine water indicates this reaction is happened, and this reaction has happened because there is an unsaturation. So if there is a decolorization of bromine water, it indicates there is a presence of unsaturation. Decolorization of bromine water indicating unsaturated compound, no decolorization of bromine water indicating saturated compound. Okay. So this is all about the preliminary test. In the next lecture, we will be discussing the elemental analysis and the solubility test. So hope you have understood whatever we have discussed. Thank you for watching this video.